Back to the Rebel Chumps channel. Today we're gonna do a quick update on the channel to show you what's going on, and I got some feedback from you guys, so I got already two people that are willing to play with me, and it's awesome. So let's hook up in game, add me in game on the Harbinger server, Hampers is the name, or I can add you if you give your in game name on the Hamburger server. Oh, what's happening here? Hamburger server, Hamburger. anyway, so I start to level up my character. It's now level 25. I take my time. I'm not in a hurry. I just wait for you guys. I got the purple lightsaber from the cartel market. I think this one was awesome. It's a really cool lightsaber. Probably everybody has one, but I think it was pretty cool. It's a nice violet, soft violet color. And it matches the gear pretty good, the Mystic set. I think that's pretty cool looking together. And I've been selling some stuff from the cartel market as well. So I get half a million, or nearly half a million credits. So that really helps me to speed up the process of getting money to pay off the geld and the geld ship and whatnot, because I believe those are ridiculous expensive, like 5 or 10 million credits. So it's gonna cost me a lot of money, but I'm looking forward to have my geld ship and having fun with all the geldies together. That's the most important thing, and that's the whole main reason why I like to watch games myself. I'm a big fan of, for example, Frankie on PC. Frankie on PC, what he does is he plays with close friends, and then he makes a story-driven video. And I like that more than other YouTubers, where they just show highlights, where they show off like, oh, I'm very good at this game. Look at my super skill sets. But those videos are highly edited. I don't feel they're personal, there's no story behind them, and most importantly, there's no bonding, no group. You cannot feel there's a group of friends playing together and having fun and doing all this idiotic stuff together, and that is really important to me. And that is what I want to achieve with this guild as well. Like, we really have fun, like casually fun, and no strings attached. You just play and have fun, and then hopefully make in-game friends for life. Yeah, that's really important to me. Just a quick final update on this video. This is one of the many sabers that I'm going to review very soon. But this is the one I keep picking up. This is the Saber Force Bastion. I really like the simplicity of this hilt. It's just basically a metal tube with or alloy tube with vertical and horizontal lines, and it's very playful, and it's just very nice to hold and play with. It's so simplistic in terms of design, but yeah, it's somehow it keeps attracting to me, and it's the saber of the day for me to keep playing with. And lastly, I'm gonna do something very typical, but I've been thinking about it for a long time, and I'm gonna actually buy a vape, like a small box with all those teenagers sucking on those things, or you see all these video gamers sucking on those vapes the whole day. The reason why I want a vape is because it's more for when it's cold, when I'm in a cold environment, let's say in Europe, when I'm back home, or here in Hong Kong, it's getting winter as well. In Hong Kong we have winters, it gets around 10 degrees minus. And the most cold weather is around 10 degrees, it's not minus 10 degrees, but still feels chilly. You wear your jacket, etc. But I just felt like I wanted to try it out. I try out the vape. I'm not a smoker. I don't smoke, and I'm originate from Holland, so yeah, we do smoke other stuff, and I like to smoke that, but no way I'm gonna do that in Hong Kong and jeopardize my my stay here. It's illegal here, and it's great, I love it, but it's not like I can not live without. So for me, no, last 7 years didn't touch it. because that's how long I live in Hong Kong. But anyway, I just want to try a vape. I think it's a pretty cool thing. You know, it's modular. It's like a lightsaber. You can put all kinds of attachments on it and enhancements. And I'm not really into like the cloud chasing, like making massive air of clouds and stuff like that. I don't care about that. I just want to try the different flavors, like non-nicotine versions, like the oils where you have like a strawberry or a fruity taste and stuff like that. I think that that's something I like to try, and it's also just to have something to do in the winter time. Like for me, winter time smoking cigarettes, it is because of course I have a big influence from World War II, World War I movies. I'm a big fan of that era, and I read up a lot on the history, and I actually have several uniforms from the Soviet soldiers in World War II, and some of them Germans and US soldiers. I used to do a lot of reenactment, really cool, awesome stuff if you're into it. Very expensive, by the way, for the good uniforms and whatnot. But just the winter time when it's really cold, you want to smoke a cigarette, you just, I don't know, it's just me, I'm just weird, okay? So, but I saw this Subox vape. It's a brand called Kangoo or something. I don't know anything about these things, I don't read up too much about it, but it's a probably one I'm gonna buy, a mini box, 75 watts or something. You guys probably know what I'm talking about. It's like 50 or 60 bucks with some oils and stuff like that, so I think it was a fair price to try it out, and hopefully that will help me to get my wife off smoking cigarettes and instead smoking that stuff, because there should be no nicotine in there. Hopefully a little bit less cancerous. I don't think it's good either. So if you're a younger person and you're watching this, I still don't recommend you to go vape, honestly. But it's there. That's it. The people coming inside. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Hello.